22 years of age. And so I started a bulb factory, miniature bulbs, because I thought I'll supply them to Mahindra and Mahindra. And so I got in on, I'm not an engineer, I'm just a commerce postgraduate and then a graduate in philosophy. So I got into this and didn't know a damn thing about that industry, but my parents were kind enough to give me the money to set up the industry. I set it up. Then I went to Mahindra's with my bulbs, and they tested and they found them to be extremely substandard. I had got them the technology from a party in Pune. So those, they said, you better upgrade your technology. That means more money and you know, investing in plant and machinery, which my family said, je adi banola te vikun dakho, which is very right, ki jo tune banaya hai wo pehle bech ke to bata, baad mein paisa dalna ki nahi dalna hum sochenge. To usko bechna tha. So what did I do? I came out with a small novelty torch which had a dog, and it was called Ricky novelty torch, and I put the miniature bulb in the torch. So to sell the bulbs, I started a torch factory with a injection molding outsourced facility, and then at the end of it, to cut the story short, I sold it off because I couldn't make it into a success. That was one. Then I put in a truck on a contract basis. I lost money doing that because transportation of Nepa mills for the bamboos in Madhya Pradesh, it was a very big opportunity, and everybody said, khub paisa hai isme, khub paisa hai. So I got into that. It was not my cup of tea. And like that, I've burnt monies doing a lot of things. God has been kind. I'm alive, and my financials are not very bad, though I could have been doing much better. Fact of the matter is, I enjoyed doing everything I did. I have no regrets. And if my wife ever says to me that you burnt up so much money, you lost so much money, she stops saying it. But when she says that to me, I tell her, please allow that much, because I enjoyed doing it. I enjoyed creating that. At this age in my life, thanks to my friend Nitin Gadkari, we have now got into a travel and tour company business to bring in inbound tourists into Tiger Country, Central India. There's no need for me at the age of 61 to get into a business. But I believed in it. I said, here is an opportunity. Nobody's exploring this. Tiger Country needs to be marketed to the globe. We need to get tourists here. They must see the beauty of our forest. Right from Chikaldara in the west to Panna in the north, there's such splendorous that are available for tourism, which need to be developed and promoted. So I've got into it. Again, this is the same story. We are struggling. It's a tough business. I should have learned better. But anyway, I'm enjoying doing it. This is the reward of entrepreneurship. If you can afford to, you'll enjoy doing it. But what is the risk? There are two R's, reward and risk. Which is the first risk? You've not been listening to me or what? Sore kya? Loss. That's a big risk. So what do you do as a smart young entrepreneur? What would you do? You will take a risk that is calculated and that is properly hedged. Don't rush into things. Go in a very studied way. Study all the pros and cons. Yeah? Smart boy, smart, very nice. Learn at somebody else's cost. Don't make a partnership. Learn at his cost and start your own later. That's what people do. Partnership means he'll ask you to put the money. Who will give you partnership without money? So what you do is, what you've said is very right, that first you hone your skills, whatever skills you've acquired, you hone them in the practical world by taking up a job, learning all those ropes that need to be learnt, and then start off on your own. So your risk is minimized. You know what it takes to do a thing and how to market it and make your money. That's one very good idea. What else?
Dan to 15 years, and then I will get some information from my friends who belong to different fields, such as marketing, advertising, and production units. Then I will start with my business with help of them.
Good. Now see, you all are young, very young. Yes.
No, sir, like you said, the Marwadi and the Gujarati communities are one of the best communities in business, or Sindhi, even the Sindhis in India are very much ahead in business.
Oh, yes, yes, yes.
So, once I was speaking with one of my Gujarati friend's father, and he told me that, pehle bechna seekho. So, he told me, pehle bechna seekho, aur fir production mein aao.
So, पहले क्या सीखो
बेचना
ओके लर्न मार्केटिंग फर्स्ट
सो एग्जैक्टली व्हाट ही वाज ट्राइंग टू टेल मी दैट फर्स्ट गेट इनटू ट्रेडिंग एंड देन यू नो मैन्युफैक्चर योर ओन गुड्स सो दैट इज व्हाट इज गोइंग टू गिव योर गुड एक्सपीरियंस फर्स्ट एंड देन यू कैन डेफिनेटली बी अ बेटर बिजनेसमैन यू नो एंड अगेन आई वुड लाइक टू गिव अ एग्जांपल ऑफ कैप्टन गोपीनाथ ही वाज द एंटरप्रेन्योर हु स्टार्टेड द डेक्कन एयरलाइंस द डेक्कन एविएशन एंड थिंग्स लाइक दैट सो ही वाज द पर्सन हु स्टार्टेड You know, he was the first person who started, you know, was a private person, private entrepreneurship, private partnership, which started the airline industry in India. You know, after the Jet Airways and the Indian Airlines, he was the one. And he actually tapped the entire helicopter market in India. And he was the first to sense it that all the business people, the business community all over the world comes to India for different conferences and different meetings. But then they don't have, you know, good transport system for them. And they are really rich people and really important guys out there, and they need to have this helicopter facility. So he started his own helicopter company, and he started providing them with helicopters, and then he started his own airlines.
Yeah.
So this is like a story of a person who was a farmer, and from a bullock cart, from owning a bullock cart, he went to own an airline. So even he was the person.
Yeah, your point is well made. Yeah.
Exactly. So yeah. He was the person who started an agency of Hero Honda first. And then, you know, he was a trader, and then through that he started an agency of helicopters. You know, he used to buy helicopters.
Yeah, we got it's all in his autobiography, Simply Fly.
Exactly.
I've read that. And what the point you're trying to make is very clear. He's saying learn marketing first and then get into manufacturing. The bane of Nagpur as a city is, please sit down. The bane of Nagpur as a city is that, you know, we in Vidarbha Economic Development Council have been trying our best to create industrial culture and environment in Vidarbha. Mihan is one of the finest infrastructure projects that is available in our country. But hardly any local entrepreneur has come forward to set up his industry in Mihan. Everybody is waiting for someone outside to come and set up an industry here. We are lacking. So what happens is in trade, you make money with a lot of comfort. I have been a trader myself also. And in trading, you are assured that jo maal hai, wo bika jayega. Profit kam jada ho sakta hai. But there is hardly any opportunity for loss unless you are a bloody fool. But otherwise, you make money. Now, industry is a risk. It's a totally different thing. And I have not seen many people graduate from trading into manufacturing. Trader becomes this person who is very secure with his trading and doesn't get into it. Whereas a person rendering services, who is ready to take the risk because he's as good as his last service. Catering. Now Mr. Kamdar is here. He knows catering is such a tough business that you are as good as the last plate that was served by you to the customer. If that goes wrong, he's going to badmouth to 100 people, कि वहाँ मत खाना रे वहाँ भयंकर खाना दिया उन्होंने. You may have said कि मैं साल भर इतना अच्छा खाना दिया, एक इसमें गलती हो गई तो इतना बर्बाद है. But that is what service industry is all about. Whether it is you doing travel agency, you are doing catering, you are doing any other service, it's those people can get into industry. But the risk of coming back to the point, the risk of doing entrepreneurship, one is money. The other is you are going to put all your stakes in one basket and you're going to give the best of your life, time of your life in creating that enterprise. This is the risk. But everybody doesn't start with the same this thing. Those who do not have capital, this is now knowledge-driven economy, as they say. So invest in your technical expertise. Become expert in that subject in which you want to have your entrepreneurship, so you don't have to pay for the cost of getting an expert. So I would therefore just sum up that there are rewards which are far, far larger than the risk involved. Each one depending upon your circumstance, the kind of capital that your parents are ready to risk for your enterprise, or otherwise the kind of technical expertise you acquire. Get into this entrepreneur mode from right now. And the starting point, according to me, is read autobiographies and biographies of successful entrepreneurs. Start from there. This young man has read Simplify. How many of you have read Simplify? Captain Gopinath's autobiography. If you haven't, borrow it from a library or buy one. It's worth it. And similarly, you will find Creation of Wealth. This is another nice book which is written about the Tata Enterprises, how it all started. It's a compilation, it's a very nice book, and of course there are many, many which you will find are available. Get into that so that you also start thinking that, can I possibly design my life after these successful people? Why should you go wrong? I'm sure you'll succeed. It's heartening to see all of you in such a large number gathered here for your future. Wish you all the best. When you become successful entrepreneurs, I'll be a much, much older man. But I look forward to seeing some of you as very successful entrepreneurs. Thank you, Rahul, for having me. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Vilas sir. I now request our President Rahul to please give memento to Vijay sir and Vilas sir.